In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a fillable form using the content control form fields in Microsoft Word. These are form fields that you can create. You can create a form where the user can pick a date from a dropdown or insert text into your form, a checkbox or a dropdown, or even a dropdown that's customizable, something called a combo box that lets the user pick from a predefined list that you create from your dropdown, as well as type in their own answer or response. So this is the type of form fields that you can create. You can create any type of form. In this video, I'm going to show you using a template form that I created for an employee status change form. So I have another video that I created using legacy tools, and those are form fields that are compatible with earlier versions of Microsoft Word. They're very simple. There's about three different options that you can use in legacy tools: a text box, a drop-down list, or a text form field, and they show up as gray boxes on your form. The content control form fields that I'm going to show you today, instead of showing up as a gray box for your user as the form field, there'll be a light gray text prompting the user so that they know that it's a form field or a field that they need to click on to select or fill in. All right, so let's get started. This is again the template that I'm going to use today. Simply go up to the Developer tab in Microsoft Word. Make sure that your design mode is selected under the control section. Over here are all of the icons that are all of the different content control form fields that you can use for your form. So I'm going to go ahead and insert the date picker. And then I'm going to select it and go up here to properties. And this is going to open up your text box, and you can actually select the format that you want the date to return. So your user will have a drop-down calendar. They can pick the date. And then this is the box where you're saying, well, I want it to appear as, you know, whatever format of the date that you want. And then you would just click OK. Then you can put your cursor wherever you want to insert your next text box. And here on my form, I'm going to insert a plain text text box. And the reason I'm going to use plain text is so that if you use the rich text, that is a form field where users can hit tab or enter, and it lets the user continue to fill out that form field. So, and it won't let the user tab into another form field. The user actually has to click into another form field. So I prefer to use a plain text form field if it's something simple, like just for their name. So you use the plain text form field, and you can just, again, put your cursor wherever you want that form field and just insert it. Now, let's come down here to the employment status section of our form, and this is an area of the form where I want to insert a drop-down list. But instead of just a drop-down list, I'm going to use the combo box. And the reason I want to do that is so that I can create a drop-down list for my user in case one of the options that I give them is an option that they want to select. But the combo box also allows them, instead of selecting one of the options that I give them, the user can type in their own answer. So that's the difference between just a pure drop-down list, which is, this is just the plain drop-down list content control, versus the combo box content control, which is right next to it. That's the difference between those two. So I'm going to use the combo box and insert that. And then I select it and hit properties. And it opens up this list, and I'm going to come down here and hit add. And I'm going to say active is one option and click OK. And I'm going to hit add and say inactive as another option and click OK. And that is my combo box, and I'm going to show you how an end user will use that once we restrict the form. Let's scroll down here, and let's go ahead and insert a checkbox. So we just want to insert a plain checkbox here and another checkbox right here. Now, once we have all of our form fields filled out on your form, you've inserted all of the different content control form fields that you want on your template, go back up and close out design mode, and then click on restrict editing. The restrict editing window will come up, and you want to make sure that under number two that checkbox is checked, and that the dropdown is selected for filling in forms. Okay, and then you can hit number three, which is yes, start enforcing protection. You do not have to put a password. You can put a password in there. If you put a password, make sure you remember what it is. But I haven't used a password, so I'm going to just click OK. And now I can close the restrict editing window over here. And this is how the form will appear to my user. So I can send it to them, and all they can do is click in or tab through the different form fields. So you'll notice the date picker is nice. They have a little drop down. It has a calendar view where they can select the date that they want to insert, and it returns the formatted date that we selected that we wanted it to show. And then here they would tap or click and enter in their name, and then they could tab down. So let's go to the choose an item where we have the drop down for active or inactive, right? But remember, we made this a combo box, so the user can actually come in here and type something if they wanted to. They could actually override what was in there and type on leave, for an example. Now, if that were just a drop-down box, they wouldn't be able to do that. They would only be able to select from the available options. So that's what the combo box has to offer for you. Now, remember, if you start using legacy tools as your form fields on your form, stick with those throughout your entire form. Likewise with content control form fields, if you start using the content control form fields, then stick with those throughout your entire form. The reason you don't want to mix and match legacy tool form fields and the content control form fields is because then your end user may have trouble tabbing through the form fields once you restrict that editing for filling in forms. Be sure to check out my website, SharonSmithHR.com, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, feel free to do so. You can click on the bell and you'll receive a notification every time I post a new video. If you like my video, be sure and give it a thumbs up, and leave me a comment in the comment section. If you ever have any questions, I'll be glad to help. Thanks for watching.